Mr. Felipitio, and distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. Good morning. Indonesia, in the last 1 year, had been consolidated the fisheries resources, the marine resources, under new government led by President Joko Widodo and Bapak Yusuf Kalla. The visions of the President is to bring back the prosperity of Indonesia as a maritime country. We want to build back our strength as the central gravity of marine activity around the region. In this matter, the President appointed me was a surprise upon appointment. I came from a commercial world for almost 30 years, starting my small seafood business in 1983, becoming a leverancer, sending my fish and my lobster to the cold storage and exporter around Java area. In the last 10 years, I was busy with my online businesses. The two experiences in business brought me to the place where I am right now, and I want to contribute what I had experienced for the country and for the fisheries and the marine resources prosperity. In the last 30 years, there have been many things, especially in the last 10 years, I'm witnesses a lot of things. How fisheries resources depleting. How the numbers of shrimps and fish in small little village are decreased every single year. Until one day, everything is stopped. There's nothing to export anymore. And even hard to find to eat. Tuna is one of the, I'm living from the coastal, from West Java, the coastal line of West Java. Tuna is one of the commodity that's once in a while we see. But no one is specifically fishing for tuna. Was no tuna industry. When the season are coming, we found some big yellowfin. 50 kg or 70 kg. Until the last 15 years, we never see them anymore. When I take my post in the office, I try to look to all the data that we had in the office, from all businesses and fisheries, what can we do to strengthening and need empowering? To guard the visions of the President that Indonesia, with second largest coastal line in the world, almost reached 97,000 kilometers, 5,800,000 square kilometers, ocean territories. Our export for seafood is number 3 in Southeast Asia. The controversy and ironic number. We have to study and to assess, to do an appropriate policy where we want to go and how we have to start to revitalize and revolving our marine resources to become a strong roller of economy for our nations. To remind everyone here, Indonesia has 250 million population right now. The third democratic country, the biggest democratic country, number 3 in the world. We are, with 250 million population, it's a big nations, but also a lot of marine resources that we can live from. But the numbers of fishermen household in the last 10 years, from 2003 to 2013 data, decreased from 1.6 million to only 800,000. It's a signal that living as a fisherman is not enough. to support your family and become a good livelihood for the people. We lost 115 exporters of seafood in the same 10 years, which is value of almost $4 billion. I do understand there are few of mismanagement in the company. It's happened, the business is collapsed. But most of them is because of lack of raw material to process. Learning and assessing the data we had, we found that we had been concessed 1,300 fishing licenses to 1,300 vessels. And actually, what it operates is almost 7,000 to 10,000 fishing vessels around in our water. Indonesia has a very strong regulation on fisheries from 2009, which we can enforce our tough punishment for any IUU activity in our water. To start on revitalizing, I was inviting all the ambassador of our region, the region neighborhood. We continue to work together and support each other, but I do want that we will enforce our strong regulations on any IUU practice in our water. So a month after that, we all agree that IUU fishing is not only Indonesian problem, it's also our neighbor country problem. China, Thailand, Philippines, and Vietnam, and Malaysia, also Australia, we all agree that IUU fishing in no manner should allow to operate in our water. It's not only depleting your fish resources, but from what we do in the last 1 year, after we issue moratorium to force for a break through for analysis and evaluation and banning the transshipment in our territory. We find out that it's not only fish. IUU fishing is not just about fishing fish and taking your fish out, but also many other crimes are involved in it. From human trafficking, drug smuggling, alcohol smuggling, food smuggling, for anything that the operation is needed, but also for anything that people is needed, from sugar to rice to anything else. It's distorting for all your good governance. They despite all your customs regulations. Everything in and out. And the last is human trafficking. We investigate a case in Benjina as an example. We have been so far sent out back home almost 4,000 Burmese and Myanmar from Benjina Islands. Many of them have been taken from their family for a hope to get a job inland. Somewhere in big city in Asia, in Thailand, in Bangkok, or in Malaysia. But what's happened? They end up in an island in Indonesia, far away from home, they don't know what's the name of the place. Until 22 years later, Indonesia combating and eradicating illegal fishing helped him to be home again. And also we investigate another hundreds of thousands other Indonesian seamen that right now operate in all fishing vessels around the globe. Many of them operate in Africa, many of them in New Zealand water, many of them in Pacific. I would remind to all of us today here, to all the Western Pacific Tuna or Fisheries Commission, while we discuss about our quota, how much can we do and have our business in tuna fisheries, we also remember and look deep into other side of this business, the quota of human rights that we have to fulfill and committed. It will be shame for us to sit here discussing and talking about a high quality and an incredible high quality of cuisine and gourmet and businesses, forgetting that human rights has to be also taken a place. Our Marine Affairs Ministerial, starting last week, announcing that human rights compliances has to be also in place in all fishing businesses activity. We want to declare it on the 10th of December that there are no more fishing businesses activity allowed without compliances into human rights. We should learn from what happened in Syria, in Africa. We do not want Western Pacific to become or to be the same situation like they have experienced right now. Every one of us has to respect that every country need to strengthen their resilience for their food security and its economic growth. We cannot say or mention, yes, this is what we think good for you and you have to do it. With all respect, we have to start on this. We should not wait until nothing to discuss or to catch anymore, because everything is fizzed out. The resilience on food security, food supply for its own, especially all the island countries, is very important. In the last 1 year, eradicating and combating LUU fishing is also giving us another incredible fact and revenue, which I want to share right now here with you. We experiencing growth of fisheries by shutting down those big vessels. Our growth are increased almost 40% to 60%. Fisheries never been growing more than 6.6%. The first quarter after we eradicate combating IUU fishing, our fisheries economic growth to 8.6. And every quarter after that, the last 1 year, four times every quarter, we experiencing growth of 8.7 and 8.9. People was hesitant in the beginning. This is will shut down the whole industry. The end, we find it different. The tuna catch is more, catch by small traditional fishermen. People talking that the fish not swimming to the shore to be catch. Our village starting getting one or two pieces big yellowfin again. It was for 50 years we never see them around anymore. Tomini Bay now catching 30, 40 kg yellowfin tuna. Sabah is hard to get 1 ton for the whole island in a day, in the normal day, in the whole day. Now they catch 20 tons every day. Such a change in an incredible also number seen in the local supply of fish. The local market supply increased almost 240%. The catch increased 40%. The IUU fishing had been depleting the marine resources, especially fish, in Indonesia millions of tons every year for the last 20 years. Another number surprising us is that actually now we are saving 37 of our diesel consumption. It's not because millions of cars are stopping operation in the last 1 year. But thousands of big vessels are stopping operation. They don't need fuel anymore in our territory. It's saving the country almost $10 billion. With so much and so good experience we have by combating and eradicating illegal fishing, we sued to do the analysis and evaluation to ministerial decree, moratorium and ban transshipment. This is two of the way most of the IUU fishing is taking practice. They transfer everything, including the exchange of their crew in the sea. If you issue 100 licenses, I do believe out there there will be at least 3 to 5 times of the license that you issue. My experience coming from interviewing all also the godfather or the ex or the Indonesian agent that they have working for this all organization. I come to one conclusion that IUU fishing is not only fishing matter. It's a big transnational organized problem. I would advise this Western Pacific Fisheries Commission to have a highlight, to start putting this issue into the agenda of the discussion. We have to put in place, we're not discussing only about quota, how many tons of tuna we can catch. We have to start also contribute our conservation shares. I want to also call all Pacific countries to start seeing that our EEZ, it also has to contribute a conservation, not only exploitation in economy-wise. More you conserve of marine resources, more sustained and productive your fisheries economy. And this is what I find out from what we have done in the last 1 year. The economic growth in such stormy days almost doubled than any other sector, where agriculture slowing from 6 or 7% to only 4%. I want to remind also to all the Western Pacific countries, especially the small island countries, by the years lately, our age of nations is getting old. We have to start thinking to plan our future. Our president said the future of Indonesia will be in the ocean. That will require us to put an appropriate management, efficient and effective. Otherwise, we will not have future in our ocean. We will have enough fish for our one generation, but will not be for more generations. Indonesia in the last 10 years experienced stunting index. One of three kids that born are small. That's also another part of sign that we are depleted in diet of enough protein and nutrients. In the last 10 years, it's difficult to find any seafood in the local market. It's getting very expensive. If there are catch, it's all for export. The economy divert into aquaculture. We're just learning aquaculture. We take all intensive advice to intensify the productivity and the growth. In other side, it's giving us fish with so high residue of antibiotics and chemicals. It's an irony for a country of 17,000 islands and the second largest coastline that we have to divert our diet menu of fish into the aquaculture, which is non-sustainable aquaculture. We learn from that and we want to fix this problem. Sustainable aquaculture has become one of our program for the next years to come. Sovereignty is very important part too. So we put sovereignty in number one program. We decide to not concess our territorial water for fishing to foreign vessel anymore. We want to revitalize and empowering our local capacity on fishing. We want to bring back the number from 800,000 to 1.6 million fisheries households. We want to be able to create another 100 enterprises that are able to export. And we want to ensure that everything is on sustainable manner. Because we want to put our nation into the oceans. The future of the nation is in the ocean. We have learned from oil productivity. 10 years ago, we are one of the big oil producers. Oil is finished, we are now net importer of oil. Mining is also decreased amounts. Agriculture is also fighting with property and other development for the space. Forest, the last burn of forest, it's been very bad and almost left us no forest anymore. The only hope for this nation is the ocean. We are taking a very tough and very strong measure. It's for the good of our nation and for the regions, not only for us. Indonesia failing, it will be very bad for economic stability, political stability, and social stability around the region. 7 million population of Syria is sending enough problem for Europe. You don't want to have 250 million having problem with its resilience on its food supply and school. A respect and regards into every country, rights and sovereignty to manage appropriately their very resources. It has to be declared and respected by all members of Western Pacific Commission. We talk about climate change. The world, 2/3 of it is oceans. We don't talk only about forests. The sea, the reefs is all the Amazon of our ocean. The destructions of our ocean reefs is also will be the biggest contributions of the climate change. Who will be affected most? Us, the people from the countries of Iceland. We isolated, but we united as a global citizen by the oceans. We all have to remember to not only take it, but preserving to make sure and assure that the resource out there. We can meet again next year and year later to discuss about tuna because we still have tuna to catch. When the tuna is gone, we don't have this discussion anymore. I don't want to take your time too much, so sharing what we have and experience. I would love to discuss more if any question coming more later for all country delegate for lunchtime. Any question from what we have done so far? I support all the good will and all the good faith of all of us here to keep Our business on fisheries, especially on tuna, are continuously sustained and growing. Without that, business is not good, and the prosperity of the people also in jeopardy. So it's very important to all of us, in one of the discussions, come to a conclusion. Quota of tons of your tuna to catch, but also quota of human rights to be in place, and quota a part of the prosperity of the inhabitants of the island is also very important. Cannot just industry coming and taking the fish out. The people have to struggle for the fish left over, which is not many anymore. Not every inhabitant of the island capable to go to supermarket, fill up their trolley with the fish. So we have to make sure, we all of you, ladies and gentlemen, to guard that the marine resources is always enough for the coastal, the island people to have at least for their diet. To have enough protein and to grow, have able competing because their brain and their body are healthy with a good healthy diet because they can catch fish so easy. Thank you.